so sorry. It is 4:32 on Monday, June 26th. Sorry. I've had no electricity, and as my daughter said, we're living like the Amish. And we are at the Arvin Education Center. This is the regular monthly board meeting for Oldham County Schools. We have an agenda, sir.
Yes, ma'am. I have four amendments I'd like to make to the agenda and present to the board for the agenda. First is the meeting schedule. I'd like to amend the July board meeting from July 24th to the 31st, and that is the first enclosure there. What I would suggest for the board is that the SPDM presentations will come back in July and ask the board to approve the SPDM reports, the meeting schedule. But what I would like for the board to amend the July meeting date, which is next month's meeting date, to the 31st. The second supplement is enclosure B1. You can see there that we received bids, and Mr. Bohannon is here. He can answer any questions that you have, but we opened bids for the Oldham County Middle School project for the STEM lab, essentially, and we only received one bid, and so we're wanting to not accept that and reopen bids at a later time this summer because we felt like the bids that we received, the one bid that we received was high, and we wanted to be very good stewards of our taxpayer dollars. The third amendment is enclosure O. That outlines all of the policies that we're asking the board to approve, which is tied to, we discussed at our July or our June mid-month meeting, June 14th, and this is tied to legislative action that the legislature took in the spring. And so these policies would be a second read and ask the board to approve that. That just outlines what those policies are and the policy number. The fourth amendment is policy 10.5, and that would just draw your attention to the first page there for registrants, that the principal and the board, not the principal or the board, but the principal and the board have given full disclosure to who would visit and be aware of what that is. So that's all the amendments I have for the agenda, Board Chair.
Okay. Could I get a motion to approve the agenda as amended? Made by Mr. Dennis, seconded by Mrs. Sheffer. All those in favor? And that's 5-0. At this time, we're going to do the Pledge of Allegiance. Mr. Shelton, will you lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America. And to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Mr. Dodson, would you mind reading us into executive session?
Let me bring it up here. Okay. At this time, I need a motion to go to executive session pursuant to KRS 61-801-8101K and KRS 156-557-6C for preliminary discussion related to evaluation of superintendent by the board.
Okay. Can I have a motion to go into executive session made by Mr. Dennis, seconded by Mrs. Sheffer? All those in favor? And that's 5-0. In conformance with the superintendent's, In conformance with the superintendent's contract, the board is required to perform a year-end evaluation on or prior to the July board meeting. In keeping with KRS 156.557, while in executive session, the board conducted a preliminary discussion of the year-end evaluation of the performance of Superintendent Radford in closed session. The process of conducting the superintendent's evaluation was as follows. Evaluation documents were sent out to board members in June. Board members were given approximately 2 weeks to complete their documents and return them to me. The board members were asked to use the following ratings: exemplary exceeds the standard, accomplished meets the standard, Developing makes growth toward meeting the standard, growth required to be addressed in the professional growth plan. Board members were encouraged to provide comments when appropriate. These preliminary results were discussed and a formal evaluation was prepared in executive session on June 14th. The evaluation document centers on the 22-23 standards adopted by the board for the superintendent. The standards include strategic leadership, mission, vision, review of data, instructional leadership, teaching and learning, cultural leadership, trust and support in the community, human resource leadership, highly effective, diverse staff, managerial leadership, operations and resources, collaborative leadership, partnerships, success after graduation, and influential leadership, board relationship, policies and regulations. Each of these standards is measured by multiple indicators. Dr. Radford received a rating of accomplished on 6 out of the 7 standards and exemplary on standard 7, influential leadership. It is the consensus of this board that Dr. Radford, in his second year as superintendent, has met the standards set forth by the KSBA. Dr. Radford has worked hard to engage with community members and all stakeholders to help create a strategic plan for Oldham County Schools, and the board looks forward to the rollout and implementation of this plan during the 2023-2024 school year. As always, student learning remains at the center of the focus of Oldham County Schools, the superintendent, and the board.
Thank you, Madam.
Oh, I'm sorry. I need a motion to approve the superintendent's evaluation that we did. Made by Mr. Dennis, seconded by Mr. Dotson. All those in favor, and that's 5-0.
Thank you, Madam Chair, and to each of our board members. I really appreciate the feedback and the work that, and the diligence that you did in going into the evaluation process. So really appreciate the feedback, and any success that we have as a board team is also could not be possible without the hard work of our district staff and district leaders. So thank you, and thanks to everyone.
Next item, sir.
Yes, ma'am. I'd like to invite Dr. Shelton to come forward and share the treasurer's report with the Board of Education.
Good evening. I'd like to share with you our treasurer's report and answer any questions that you might have. We had another good month. I will tell you that included in the receipts that you see there of $21.5 million includes the $12 million of the bond proceeds that, from your most recent bond sale for the athletic fields project. But even with that included in the receipts, we still ended the month very positively. We're still well under our disbursements and expense budget, and we ended with $65.7 million in cash in all funds. We have bonded construction funds, which Mr. Bohannon and I are working on reconciling all of those projects that are listed separately there for you. And we still are maintaining in excess of $17 million in other investments. So our total assets are just under $73 million. The breakdown of that is on the second page. Behind that, you have, as you normally do, a summary of some of the comparisons of our historical actuals and in particular accounts. You can see our revenue is just right at over budget, which is always a good thing to have revenue that exceeds budget at 101% of our budget. And our expenses are well within control, as I mentioned earlier. Still maintain our strong contingency. One thing I would note for you is last month I mentioned that our capital outlay funds, we would receive the balance of those in May, and we did. I was expecting that we would receive the balance of our equalization for our building fund from the state in May. We actually didn't receive it till June the 6th, and so that was a little bit late, and so it'll be included in your June report. You have the report of the food services fund following there, as well as the balance sheet for all funds, and then the detailed income statement. But I'm happy to answer any questions that you might have on the treasurer's report.
Board members, any questions? Okay.
I do have one.
Yes.
On these, you got about 2, 4, 6, 7 different items here on the right.
He may not be able to see.
Well, it says Board Treasurer's Report May, Operating Treasurer's Report. Is there any way that they can be put in the order that you present them?
Yes, absolutely.
Because sometimes you got to jump around.
Right. Well, that's more me probably than it is anything, Mr. Dotson, as I jump back and forth. But I'll make sure that they're in that.
It'd make it easier for us to follow, you know, first one, second one, third.
So, Dr. Shelton, I tend to.
So, Dr. Shelton, Mr. Dotson's referring to in e-meetings, how when you open up e-meetings, how those attachments
correct
are laid out.
Right.
So.
Yeah, and what I'll do is you see that the first two show a number beside them. They show number one and then number two. I'll make sure that each of the files are numbered, and then when I refer to them when I'm presenting, I'll tell you which number I'm talking from and make it easier for you to follow.
And we got two number twos, so.
Yeah. Yeah, there's a 2 and a 2A, okay. Yeah. So.
Thank you.
That would help a whole lot.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
Any other questions?
Recommendation, sir?
Yeah, recommend to approve as presented.
Have a motion to approve the treasurer's report made by Mrs. Sheffer, seconded by Mrs. Klim. All those in favor, and that's 5-0. Next, we have meeting minutes to approve. There are 2 sets of meeting minutes. The first is the May 22nd regular meeting minutes. Board members, do you have any corrections or changes to those? Can I have a motion to approve those minutes made by Mr. Dennis, seconded by Mr. Dodson? All those in favor, and that's 5-0. The next set is the June 14th special called meeting minutes. Any changes or corrections to that? Can I have a motion to approve made by Mrs. Klim, seconded by Mrs. Sheffer? All those in favor, and that's 5-0. Next, sir.
Next is, my bearings here, is the personnel reports, and I would just, my recommendation would be to take the report under advisement and direct the superintendent, myself, to include as part of the minutes of the meeting, and also Ms. Easton.
Got it. Board members, any questions?
Is it accurate that we're getting more hires than people that left the district according to that report?
Yes, so that's something we're watching very closely, Mr. Dennis. A great question. As we know, July, the date I have to double check if I'm correct on the date. One of the other things I'm cautious about is July 15th, the date that we can release people from their contract if they were to be offered another position. So that's a date that we're watching very closely, so that way we can provide a really accurate summary. So we're right now we feel pretty good compared to how we've been the last 2 years, but we're watching very closely.
Thank you.
Okay, next, sir.
Okay, navigating my e-meetings.
10.
Yes, ma'am. So consent items. My recommendation to the board would be to approve as presented. Also with the addition of the couple of amendments that we made at the beginning of the meeting.
Okay, board members, any questions about the consent items?
The only thing I have is, Brent, we are good with the other playgrounds, correct? Adding them to the BG at the end.
That would be on a separate BG. Similar name project, a separate BG, because we funded that project today.
When we get Kenwood done.
Yes.
But if they want playground equipment, that's going to, we got to get the school that what they
we'll
want.
With the support organization to all right purchase that equipment so that it's installed while the playground's being worked on.
Perfect.
And that would be multiple schools. Mm-hmm. The rest of the schools that haven't been touched yet, and reworking some of them that we did back in 2018 as well.
All right. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Your recommendation?
Yeah, recommend to approve.
Can I have a motion to approve the consent agenda items made by Mr. Dodson, seconded by Mrs. Klim? All those in favor, and that's 5-0. Next is public expression. Mr. Williams, we don't have anyone signed up for public expression today. Okay, into action items, sir.
Yes, ma'am. Bearings here. First action item is consider approval of policy revisions due to legislative action for FY24 as submitted by KSBA. And that was one of the amendments that we made to outline all of those policies at the beginning of the meeting this afternoon.
Okay. Board members, do you have any questions about the KSBA policy revisions?
The only thing I want to put on is I want to make sure when we revisit them, we look at the bus drivers.
CDL
reimbursement, pay for getting an exam if they're not on the clock. With help of the leadership from the district, hopefully we can work that out. And then under the visitor policy we're approving, I would like to revisit also that we make sure that our elementary schools, parents and grandparents can still visit the school to have lunch. I got some wording we can work on later about that. But otherwise, I'm okay with it.
Okay. So,
Suzanne, this is just 12A, is that right?
This is 12A, correct.
Okay. So just to publicly clarify, those 40 policies, none of those include how curriculum is chosen. That's correct, right?
That's correct. That will be, you'll see that curriculum decision or that policy in the manual that we'll bring back to the board next month.
Okay, thank you.
Yes, these are the policies that were driven by legislative actions only, not to include curriculum. Okay, can I have a motion to approve? Made by Mr. Dotson, seconded by Ms. Sheffer. All those in favor? And that's 5-0.
All right. Next action item is approval of the resolution to join the Council for Better Education.
This has been discussed prior in executive session. Board members, do you all have any questions?
I have a question. Can you remind me what the cost is associated to that?
Yes, Dr. Shelton, can you share that dollar amount?
$1 per student. So for us, it's $11,771.24.
Okay.
Do we have a 24th cent of a student, Dr. Shelton? Oh, I was going to say. They collecting taxes on that too? Can I get a motion to approve? Made by Mr. Dotson, seconded by.
I feel like I need more information on this one. I know we discussed it, but I thought we were waiting to discuss. Did we decide on the vote?
They brought out for the vote.
I just don't remember.
So the purpose of this recommendation for the board to take action on is the Council for Better Education, with legislation that's been passed that should there be a charter school that's opened in Oldham County. A couple of talking points. What that means is that currently that SEEK dollars follow the child, whether the child is in Oldham County or lives in Oldham and goes to another. But this current legislation means that local tax dollars would follow the child. And so the Council for Better Education is taking this suit against the Kentucky Department of Education, which administered the regulation, to say that that's not constitutional. That's the purpose of this action. And in addition, it takes away use. Previously, boards of education could decide whether or not a charter school could be started or opened in a school district, and this legislation takes that ability away from all school boards. So the purpose of joining this, the Council for Better Education, is to
stand up against those items.
So there is a lawsuit?
Yes. The lawsuit was filed in December, and it's already been briefed, it's already been argued. Right now, there's 132 of the school districts that have already joined a passing resolution. So this is a resolution asking Oldham County to be to support those other districts that have already joined.
Is there any benefit to passing this now versus having a further discussion on it and putting it on next month's agenda?
It'd be totally up to whatever you all want to do. The lawsuit's already well underway, so you know some districts, so there are 171 school districts in Kentucky, 132 of them have already joined.
Mm-hmm.
And there's others that are joining, you know, throughout.
So it's not urgent to join today.
It's only urgent from the standpoint of from the council's perspective. What they're asking is that all of the districts that were targeted in the legislation, there were 18 districts that were specifically targeted in the legislation that were over 7,500 students. There are only two of the 18 that are still considering joining or not. So they're asking, they would like to have all 18 of the districts that were specifically targeted in the legislation to be a part of it. That's one reason for asking.
Who's the other district?
Okay. I think there's just some confusion on my end. So if there's any way we could delay it until July, I think, from my end, but.
Can we comment? Problem with charter schools. Like Tom said, it takes money away from us the way it's worded. And even our local taxes, when we increase taxes, part of that money goes with a kid too. And it shouldn't, it should stay with us. Used to, we would have control of the charter school. They would have to come to us and we can control how they do. The way it's set up now, correct me if I'm wrong, they can have control. So they can put some kids in the charter school. And let's say they're not teaching those kids right or what have you, and they fall behind. And all of a sudden, part of their program says they don't meet our standards because they didn't give them all they need. Now where do they put them back? In our school, and we got to provide intervention to get that kid brought up.
That's correct. Maybe the most clear description of what is most likely happen is the bill specifically requires that a charter school be established in Jefferson County. And so when a school, it's not if, it's when, because the bill requires it. So when there's a charter school established in Jefferson County, if any Oldham County students went to that school, we would have to send our local tax dollars to that school under the law the way it's written.
Yeah, I think it's one thing when SEEK money goes, because that's mostly state money, but I think it's a whole nother thing when you're going to take local tax money from our district that we are constantly wanting to have to pay our teachers more and saying we're going to let that go with the kid to a school that no school board has any say over.
That's the bill specifically requires a school to be established in Northern Kentucky and one in Louisville. And it doesn't matter where the students come from, the local money will have to follow according to the law the way it was written. The state SEEK money always follows the kid. That's normal in any situation. For example, if an Oldham County student went to Shelby County schools, SEEK money follows that. That happens every day in school districts. But the board is not required to send local tax dollars that the taxpayers in Oldham County have paid along with the student. And under this charter school, you would.
How much money is that per student?
I think I understand that part of it. What I don't understand is this council can later go against something different than charter schools is my confusion. This is, am I understanding it correctly that this council is not just against charter schools? We could, a year from now, if we're part of it, we would potentially be going to get something different?
No, you'd have to vote. You're specifically asked to vote here on the charter school legislation, and that's the only thing the money is being collected for.
Okay.
Because the way the council works, for example, the most recent lawsuit that the council brought was against private school tax credits. And in that situation, what was happening was there was $25 billion per year over 5 years, $125 million that was going to be taken out of the general fund budget that would be given for private school tax credits. And so the council sued in that situation and won in that situation. That one's over. Then this charter school bill was passed, and so they're suing a second time. So they only ask districts to join for specific lawsuits, and the board gets to make that decision each time.
And so we could vote, Carly, if something came up that the five of us didn't approve of, then we wouldn't, then we would not choose to join that.
Okay. So if we're joining the CBE, it's only for this charter school issue, not something different down the road.
Perhaps it may be make better sense to change the word that I've used for joining, because it's not like you're a member. There is no membership.
Okay.
The council is a separate corporation that has filed a lawsuit. So what we're asking is the board to pass the resolution that you have before you, which authorizes the superintendent to support and work with the members of the council that brought the lawsuit and to pay the pro rata share of the legal expenses for fighting this lawsuit. It's not really joining anything like a membership, because there are no memberships.
Okay.
That's good. Ms. Clem, I appreciate your questions. That's good clarification. Dr. Shelton, thank you for clarifying. Just share with the board, because we have three of our newest board members, and for our whole board, that the first example Dr. Shelton gave about vouchers, the Board of Education at that time during my first year joined the CBE litigation to fight that for that particular purpose. So that's a good example to come back for this issue. Specifically, that's what the ask is to for CBE to help represent Oldham County and be able to feel like we certainly want to make sure we're being protective of our dollars and supporting our kids for our kids.
But we have to send money for one student. That would just about cover the cost of belonging to the doing this.
Be close.
Be pretty close.
Not quite.
Full cover, but pretty close.
It would, yes. So it's the pleasure of the board.
I'd prefer to wait and just do a little more research, just a little bit, maybe 1 month, if we have the time.
Okay, maybe we can revisit at the July 10th meeting then.
That sounds like a good plan.
That good?
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Okay.
Madam Chair, the next action item that we have is approval of the FY23 amended calendar. And for our board members, as you see in your packet, and for our audience members, this is regarding the snow days. And we have to approve not for the new school year, but for the school year that we just wrapped up. We have to approve the days that we took for snow. And so that's what's being presented to the board to approve as presented in the enclosure.
Questions, comments? Motion to approve. Made by Mr. Dennis. Sorry, I had D. Seconded by Mrs. Sheffer. All those in favor? And that's 5-0.
The next action item is to approve for our Board of Education and authorize myself to join the social media litigation against social media companies that we, our district and our Board of Education has been asked to participate. Just a reminder for our board, this does not require any monies on our part to, it is really on, we're asked to join as a, because of the harmful effects that social media has had on students. That is the purpose, and as presented in your packet.
Any questions, board members? Mm-mm. Motion to approve, made by Mrs. Sheffer, seconded by Mrs. Klem. All those in favor, and that's 5-0.
And the last action item is approval of the Oldham County Schools Strategic Plan. This was presented to you all at May's board meeting. And as presented in your packet.
Board members, any questions, comments? Motion to approve, made by Mr. Dodson, seconded by Mrs. Sheffer. All those in favor, and that's 5-0. Are we doing this? Did we already do that? Okay. Okay, information items.
Let me clarify with Ms. Easton. Ms. Easton, for our July board meeting, we've been amending the agenda. We got this in consent items for that to be moved to the 31st, correct? Yeah, making sure. Okay. Information items are as presented for the board to be made aware and as presented in your packet.
All right, that's it, boys and girls. I have a motion to adjourn, made by Mr. Dennis, seconded by Mrs. Sheffer. All those in favor, and that's 5-0.